What's going on? It's Facts You Don't Know. If it's your first time here, and you want to find out new facts that will definitely make you smarter and more well-informed, make sure to subscribe and activate the notifications bell so you don't miss anything.
It was a cold winter morning when 14-year-old John Smith fell into a cold Missouri lake. When the firefighters finally pulled him out, he'd been submerged in the cold water for 15 minutes. And at the hospital, John had no heartbeat for more than 60 minutes. After entering his room, I put my hands on his feet, and they were cold and gray, and I just knew he was gone, John's mother, Joyce Smith, said in an interview with the Gospel Herald. I began to pray out loud, begging God for my son's life and calling on the Holy Spirit, saying, "Please give me my son back," he said, and then something miraculous happened. For as soon as the prayer was over, John's pulse returned immediately, startling the nurses and doctors around him. The nurse had her finger on John's wrist for 27 minutes and got nothing, Joy said. She said to me, "The moment you prayed, something moved John's body so hard it pushed me backwards, and suddenly I caught a wrist." They were surprised, added Joyce. The incredible story of healing and restoration is the subject of Joyce's book, The Impossible. A movie's also in development through 20th Century Fox Studio by executive producer Devon Franklin, responsible for the movie Heaven is Real, aired on TV Globo in 2016. John and Joyce Smith hope that their miraculous history will demonstrate the power of prayer, the goodness and closeness of God, and that nothing is impossible when one has faith. "My family is not spreading the story for our benefit," said John. "We're doing this because our country needs hope. We're not the answer. The answer is God. We're just sharing history so that this country can see how great God is. He's not dead. He's alive, and he's still in the business of miracles. It's amazing how big he is," said the teenager. Years later, John remembers little about the accident. He, along with two friends, Josh Sander and Josh Rieger, were playing in a local park when the ice on Lake St. Louise broke, and the three friends plunged into the minus 40 degrees water. "At the moment, we all knew that the possibility of the three of us dying was very real," said one of John's friends. "Josh and I were about 50 meters from the dock, and Josh was shouting, 'I don't want to die.' I was shouting, 'Call the emergency.' Sander was saved, and I was able to push Rieger above the water, saving his life," said John, who, however, couldn't get out of the water. "I got the call hearing that my son had a terrible accident," Joyce recalled. "It's the only phone call that all parents fear. I don't even remember how I got to the hospital. I was praying, begging God to spare my son. We waited 17 years to have it. We adopted him from Guatemala. I simply couldn't believe that God would take our son after all that we'd been through. God, with his grace and mercy, eventually took me to the hospital," the mother contextualized. When Joyce arrived at the hospital, the medical staff had performed resuscitation attempts for almost half an hour without success. "When I entered the room, I didn't realize they were about to announce the time of death," she recalled. Just before the crash, Joyce participated in a Bible study that emphasized the statement that, "I believe God is what he says he is, and I believe he can do what he says he can do. I don't believe in coincidence," Joyce says of the Bible study. "When I came into first aid, I was believed that God was there, and he would be with us in this situation." After her son's pulse returned, Joyce thought the worst was over, but the doctors disagreed. "The doctor told me, 'Even if John lives, he'll be a vegetable. There's brain damage, and the only brain function is brain stem function, which is very rudimentary. I told him, do your best, God will do the rest. But I don't want to say anything about him when you're in the bedroom. I just want John to hear positive things,'" said his mother. 2 days later, John woke up and began to communicate with those around him. 7 days after awakening, John came out of the breathing apparatus, and 16 days later, left the hospital. Its rapid recovery challenged all experts, all historical cases, and all scientific predictions. To this day, John has had no side effects from the accident, despite doctors' predictions. God healed him completely. He's in high school and has returned to playing basketball. In one of his games, he scored 30 points. "God has been miraculous and very good in all things he's done," testified Joyce. Thanks for watching. Please like and share the video in social networks. We'll be right back to you as fast as we can.